Okay, my name is Petrus. I'm from South Africa. I've had the opportunity to be involved with leadership development, which has been an interesting journey. Initially, I was really against it. I felt like a lot of what was happening in the leadership development sphere was just hot air. And so as I really started looking at it, I really felt like the Lord brought it across my path. And in Central Asia, I was involved in a leadership institute, and I could teach people there about it. That's been an interesting journey, just to get to know the subject matter. And then I went to study, got some more information about it, you know, in my studies. I did an MBA, and now I'm actually involved with that full time. So I've come full circle on it, really. And I think where I'm at the moment is just really understanding we need to go back to Jesus to see what leadership is all about. And, you know, many people will say, what is leadership? You know, just look behind you. If nobody's following you, you're not a leader. And Jesus really had the opposite kind of approach to leadership. He said, if you want to be great in the kingdom, you have to become the least. You have to become the one that serves. And so we have to take our cues from Jesus about leadership and what it is, and not from the world. It's not about getting power. And I think sometimes we think, you know, if leadership is influence, I want to gain influence. And that sounds like power. And in a big way, what Jesus talked about was giving up power. And so as we think about 4:14, we're going to need children. We're going to need people in that age group that will be able to lead others. And once again, we have to go back to Jesus. How did he do it? He selected a few to spend time with. And if you look at how the churches were supposed to select elders, it's all based on competence and character. And so you need both of those at the same time. So as we look at the group of children we have to go back and say, who are the ones that's obeying the word, and how do we invest in specific ones so that they increase their ability to lead others? What Jesus did to develop his people was he spent time with them. First of all, you have to spend time with those that's got the potential, that's going to be able to lead others. Then he gave them assignments. You know, if you think about Matthew 10, Luke 10, he sent them out to the places he was planning to go. He gave them authority, and then he basically let them loose. And afterwards, they were giving feedback, and he was instructing them. And so this process of giving assignments, giving feedback, getting them to give feedback, and then looking again at the word, going back to the scriptures to say, okay, how did Jesus do it? What did we learn from Jesus? What did we learn from Acts? What did we learn from the New Testament, even the Old Testament? How did God work with his leaders? And so this process of assignment, feedback is really a step-by-step process where we develop leaders and raise them up. And the three things I've learned about how do we develop leaders, you need three things for leaders to develop. Number one, actionable information. So what is the information that I can act on that's relevant to my context? And the best place to get that is from the Bible. So read the Bible and say, how do I apply this? How do I obey this? That's the first step. Second of all, the challenge. So, and that's where we need to help people identify. If they say, I feel like I should obey it like this, make sure that's the challenge. They're trusting God in a bigger way. And then the support part of it too. So actionable information, a challenge, and support. And those three combine once again to get this step-by-step process of raising up leaders. So a few things, what's the end goal? Where are we going with this? And I think really we want people to be more and more connected to Jesus. He said, I'm the vine, you the branches. If you remain in me, you will bear much fruit. Without me, you can do nothing. And so that's the process. We always want to bring our leaders closer to Jesus and more connected, more in abiding in Jesus. And then with that, an aspect of that is growing in their knowledge of God. Growing in their knowledge of God. Paul prays this for the church in Colossae. And we need to be praying that for our disciples. We need to invest in them so that they can always increase in their knowledge of God. Understanding God's ways, growing deeper in the word. It links to being rooted as well. I want to tell the story of one of the people I am getting to work with, his name is Alan, a phenomenal young man, and somebody else discipled him very deeply. And by the time I met him, he was just passionate for Jesus. He's always living with a passion. And every time I've taught him, the next time I speak to him, he's like, I tried this, I did this. And he's always applying the words. And now he's really at the phase where he's got two or three people beneath him that he's starting to invest in, that he's raising up as leaders. And every time I'm with him now, he's like, okay, what do you think I should do with Vishy? What do you think I should do with this one? And he's reproducing himself in the leaders underneath him. And I'm telling him, you need to encourage them to start thinking about the people in their groups. Who's going to take over their groups, you know, in a year from now? How do they invest in them? And once again, select on character, select on competence, and start this process of giving feedback and giving them assignments. So in short, I think that's my story. Thank you very much.